Happy Sunday, everybody. Amy, 100 plus abandoned dogs of Everglades, Florida. So I'm going to try to be quiet and sneak in on Carol and her sister. Let's see what we get. Babe, where are you? Hi, guys. Good afternoon. So we're getting there. I thought I'd do a quick little video and update on our progress. We shut down the tunes for copyright so they don't take down our video. We've got a bed and a mattress, so we're getting there. This is the master suite. Some doggy bowls. Finishing the painting. We've been here all weekend painting, painting, and putting things up and putting things away. So, hold on, where's Carol? Sorry I woke you last night. Say hi! Say hi.
Who is that?
It's Facebook Live.
Oh.
I'm showing everybody the progress.
Maybe turn on the light.
Oh.
I think the cat.
How's it coming? Is it almost done? Oh, it looks so good.
And here's the problem. There's some extra screws.
So we missed a screw somewhere.
Hopefully there are just extras and we
didn't. No, we have to put that. It's not together. Is there a hole under it?
Yeah.
Okay, so we need a screw.
I think it's one of those things you don't like where it sticks out the bottom.
We're going to have to put it in and tighten it on the bottom. It's the only way. Yeah, I put it in the drawer in the kitchen. Right? You love the colors? So let's see. I started this. So this is when, this is the front door. And little touches makes it homey. So that's right to the right of the front door, and to the left is this room. That's our personal cat tower for our cat that we're putting together. It only took like 3 hours. And Carol painted this entire, it was gray if you remember, so it's all freshly painted. Look at how high we had, she was up on the scaffold. Look at how beautiful. And guys, no tape, she does it all freehand. So, I'm my favorite color too.
Where do you want me to put the pink? Because I'll need it later for the.
Just leave it in here so it doesn't get hot. And if because I don't have the AC in the garage. The kitchen. And as you can see, we had some furniture delivered. So, it's coming together. The TV will go here. Extra fan for hot flashes. Here's our little nice console table. We did, I added these little knobs for a little color, little jazz, little bling bling. These are all free, mind you. These are my great find, Boho Pier 1. Free, 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 love free. So we got that table, end table, another end table, and coffee table. All for free. Little rug underneath, and the couch is set up in here. So picture all the dogs taking turns and running around. New stools. Stools are right here for the counter. And let's go in the bedroom, see how Carol painted in here. For any of you that are new, welcome. We're setting up our beautiful rescue house here in Loxahatchee, Florida. We're getting there. We're clearing out this room. Just have some more stuff here to go through. But this is one dog room in here. Bathroom, again. and getting this together. Still have some touch up. Carol's painting in her sleep. Sun showers outside, it's beautiful. Just a little, I'm just going, showing you around. It's coming together, beautiful. And then I'm going to take you guys outside. A little rainy. We had the screen put around the pools for safety for the doggies. Keith was here yesterday dropping off the furniture. Him and Shelly, and Princess got to run around and see. She's loving it. She couldn't run free yet because the fence is not secure, but she's loving it. And he was able to open up our she shed, Wilbur's she shed. I'm trying to stay out of the rain because I don't want my phone to get wet. But he was able to open up the she shed. Now we just have to change the lock because there was never a key that was left for us. Last time I was here, I showed you, and the she shed was locked. Couldn't get in because there was no key. Air conditioning went into the main garage and the detached garage. So now we have AC in both garages. So we are having the floors done starting tomorrow. The floors will be done in a few days. Over there is going to be Wilbur's pig pen. It's huge. And he can roam and root all over there. It's going to be, the fencing is going to set it off privately for him. I'm going to take you into the guest house where we've also been working and painting. So bear with me a second. I'm going to try to get over there without getting wet. Had to have AC replaced in this guest house because it wasn't working. It was an older AC. And we have our little doggy, yoga doggy. Never mind the dog, beware of the owners. Little touches, hello. And then a rug, an island with a bench. Little touches just to make it homey. And then we had the couch from Rescue House 2 also brought up and delivered. So the couch is in place, TV on that wall. It's actually cold in here, it's nice. Bedroom. Bed will go up against this wall. Closet is in there. Bathroom, washer, dryer. Just simple, nice big shower. And it's coming together. Fencing has started to be installed. He started putting in, as you can see, I'll do it out the window, all along these large trees, palms. The poles have been put in the ground. He started all the way around the entire property. So the posts are now in, and he even brought them, as you can see, the posts. and they go all the way down in the back. It's going to be a 6-foot black chain link all around the back. Behind the poles, there is a chain link fence that was existing. It's a shorter fence, probably about 4 feet. We were not comfortable with that, so we're doing a 6-foot chain link across the entire property. And then there's going to be vinyl fencing all across to cut us from the middle of the property so the dogs cannot get out of the property in the back. They will have no access to the front of the property. Sorry, I'm spinning around, but you can kind of get an idea. So as you know, Carol and I will be staying in the guest house for a little while till we get everything up and running. And then, of course, once we're not here any longer, we'll be close by. We will be setting this up as another dog space. But for now, we're going to put it to good use and make it home. It's small, but it'll work. It's okay. It's for the dogs. But we're just trying to make it zen, peaceful, downsizing, very peaceful. So we can be here on the property and we painted the bedroom a brighter, beautiful blue, aqua blue, sea breeze blue, so it's more cheery. Where is what doggy? I'm just showing you this video to show you we're setting up our new doggy animal rescue house up in Loxahatchee. So you can see, standing at the door of the guest house, very nice size lot. The landscaper comes every 2 weeks. He's coming this coming weekend. He was here. It's growing very quickly because of the rain, which is beautiful. That's the main house that you're looking at now. So what's going to happen is from that corner of the guest house all the way to that main house across this walkway is going to be the white vinyl fencing with the door. And the dogs will have no access from that part to behind me, which is the front. And all of the back will be completely secure. We'll actually even have a separate fence. The guest house will have its own privacy fence. As far as who is sleeping where, yes, of course, Natasha, we always treat for ticks and fleas, absolutely. As far as who's sleeping where, Shelly and Keith are here. Shelly's our employee, and she's here 5 days, 5 nights. And Keith comes with. I get the extra bonus. How lucky are we? So amazing. And they bring our 100-plus dog, Princess, with them. And Vaughn, who is our amazing rescue, is going to be sharing the room. So it will actually free up a room. Right now, it will actually free up a room so Vaughn does not have to take up a space. He's going to be sharing Shelly, Keith's room and Princess's room full time, which is amazing. So as far as where Wilbur, this is our tiki. As you can see, I'm under the tiki. And there's another little tiki over there. And all you hear up here, it's so peaceful. All you hear are roosters. That's it. Wilbur, our plan was for Wilbur to sleep in the air-conditioned she shed right there, but I'm a little OCD, so I'm thinking, what if it malfunctions? It's a hot box. I'm not comfortable. Most pigs live outside, but I'm not comfortable with that either. So what we're going to do is we're going to prop open that door and leave the AC cranking, even with the door open, and he's going to have free roam. Wilbur will have free roam in and out of the she shed, and all along over there will be his entire rooting, his own private grounds. If the rain, if it's thundering, or if anything is freaking him out, then he will be brought in and we can put him into one of the spaces, either in the main house, as he's used to living indoors, or one of the garages that are also air conditioned. So I'm going to try to take you into the detached garage, which is where, here, I love the roosters. The detached garage is over here, and this is another yard, which is completely closed off. So once that gate behind me that I just opened, this is another yard. That's the new AC unit. It's Mitsubishi Electric. It's pretty cool. We have the door there. We're going to put a doggy door in, and whoever's on, I'll show you. Sometimes it gets a little fuzzy when I'm walking over here, so just bear with me. So in here is the main, this is the four car detached garage, and tomorrow they start working on the floors. So they'll be doing epoxy, which is what we have in the Rescue House 1 currently. It's like an ocean blue. It's beautiful. And we have a brand new AC unit. It's not on right now. But if I put it on like 73, 74, it's freezing in here. It's really comfortable. And if for some reason I wanted to kick it up and make it even cooler, I've got another window unit, which cranks really hard. Can you guys see me okay? Might be a little fuzzy. All this furniture that you're seeing right here was donated by our wonderful follower, Ellen. Thank you so much. Ellen actually came here with two of her wonderful guys, and they donated and delivered five smart TVs. So we have five TVs that we do not have to spend money on. We also have two other TVs that were donated from another supporter of ours. We also have that leather couch and... there's two leather couches, couch and love seat. They're like brand new leather, and another white leather couch, so we can put all of this to good use. She had some other items on her truck, like this dresser of drawers, and I said, absolutely, we'll take it. So for storage, for whatever, a little table, this chest right here of drawers, we can always paint it, but it's great for storage, for whatever, towels, blankets. Honey, I wanted you to see this. Yeah, I'm gonna put this on for right now.
That's insane.
Isn't it? It gets so cold in here. That's so cold. Awesome. I haven't even, look at these couches that were donated. Aren't they beautiful?
Beautiful.
Five TVs, couch, love seat.
You gotta keep the air on with these TVs in here.
Why?
Because there's components in these TVs.
It's not that hot.
It's very hot.
It is?
The humidity.
All right,
so. You might screw them up.
Okay, well then we gotta get them hung.
79. Yeah, you gotta have some air in here.
It's hot?
Yeah, well, okay. It's humid.
Do you see what I was talking about, babe, about all these shelving?
Yeah.
They need to be painted?
Mm-hmm.
But do you really think, like, we need to paint this garage?
We'll see.
See how it goes? It's
not,
concrete.
It's not the top thing on my list, but I'll get to it when I think about it.
All right. So I have to keep the AC on. Okay, well, I'm not gonna keep it on 70.
Yeah, you have
can I keep it on 78?
Yeah. As long as you keep, it's very humid. Just to get
it really is. Sorry, guys, I lost you for a minute, but I'm back. If you're frozen still, go out and come back in. Okay, locked.
Which way are you going?
I'm gonna, I gotta lock up that gate, but that's okay. Where are you going? Huh? Crazy? I don't. She always does that. She marks.
That pink paint was solid, but it's enough for me to stick my finger in, and I covered the stuff with my finger.
So we don't need to get more of it?
The pink?
We're done with it?
Yeah, but it's no good.
You just throw it out?
There's no air on it, and you got paint on it.
What's in the garage? So there's the other unit they did in this garage, same air conditioning?
Yeah, I know. Cal showed me. That's really cool.
It's very,
very cool.
Very cool. And then we have right here, this is what you're seeing. So I need goats. No, I don't need goats. Listen, I already have a hard enough time having Wilbur be outside. So if I have any goats or horses, they're going to be inside the house. We need to pull these trees too. When we got the house tented, it killed the bushes, a couple of bushes. Wipe your piggies. Oh, the little doggies.
Oh, I love
that. Isn't it cute?
This is garbage, right?
Yeah. Is this good now, babe?
No, I didn't put this.
The screw in? You got to put the screw in.
I know, but it's the one you don't like.
Well, it has to be.
How can you see it?
We did great. It's hot.
It's this one that you don't like.
We have to do it. It's not secured.
You're not supposed to have this many screws. We have too many screws left, and that's concerning.
you guys did something wrong.
No, that goes, this goes.
Oh. We're just missing one screw. Maybe they give us extras.
It's very cute though. She's going to like it.
She'll like it. I'm telling you, that is my least favorite thing, is putting things together.
How about that move?
Because it needs a screw, babe. This is what we deal with. We repeat, repeat, repeat. Just put it in. Hey, Deb, let me ask you a question. Do we have any more short screws?
Don't put something that's not supposed to.
We have one.
Will the piece that you twist on the bottom underneath it, does that fit on the short screw?
Oh,
maybe it won't be as long and stick it out. I don't know.
You're so smart.
Ow. I don't know if it'll work. Does it? Does it fit?
I don't know.
No, check first to see if it fits on the screw before you put it in. You know what I mean? See if that piece goes on. It does? There you go. Do that. Then it won't be hanging out too long. Looks great. It looks phenomenal. It really does.
I still have quite a bit to do, but I'm getting...
Oh, and in here... So, yeah, this is our... I don't have any lighting. Okay. To get the light replaced in here. But the AC is on that wall, so we're going to paint this garage. The floors will be done. And then this room will be completely sealed off, cleaned out. And it will become the dog room. We have the leather couch we'll put in here, and rugs and toys and all kinds of dog beds. And we're gonna have a TV somewhere put up in here. If not a TV, because it's a garage, I don't know, we'll see. I'm hoping, I'd like to put a TV in here. But yeah, this is our beautiful progress since we purchased May 11th. May 11th. And we're super, super, super excited. It's coming, really coming together. We have been here day in and day out. I've been driving back and forth, and we come up, Carol and I, on the weekends. We've had help from our wonderful friends, Leslie and Kevin and Shelly and Keith. And Lisa and Carol came up here to help a couple of times, which is so wonderful. But it's very, very... Oh, okay. All right, so you got to use the long one. Oh, well. It's very, very, very exciting. And yes, we did... Hello, guys. We did rescue... Hi. Sorry, tired. Very, very little sleep last night. We did take in two new babies late last night. The video is actually on our Facebook page, Precious and Peaches. For any of you that may have missed it, her owner apparently was very ill mentally, and they found her outside roaming, naked, shaved her head. This is what I was told by the girls that brought the dogs to us last night. She was outside, she shaved her head, she was roaming naked. Eating grass, and they committed her, they put her in a home. She was Baker-acted. So we got them surrendered to our organization. Peaches is a purebred Pomeranian, sweet as sugar, 5-6 years of age, and Precious is some rare breed, Yorkie mixed breed that Carol looked up, and it's identical. Very rare and very costly breed. I never heard of it myself because I'm not into breeds. I'm into saving lives. But Precious is the second dog, and she's 4. And they are completely bonded, and they have to stay together. So we need to find them a loving home together. You guys are throwing a lot of questions at me, and I'm sorry, but they're going by really fast, so I can't answer them. I apologize. There's just a lot of comments coming at me. And then, of course, the puppies. The 3 puppies are thriving at Christine and Bob's. I actually need wet puppy food. So if anybody can donate, I'm going to add it to, I think I already added it to our wish list on Amazon. We need wet puppy food. They stopped making Nutro, so I had to order Wellness and I think Solid Gold wet puppy food. It's on our wish list. We desperately need puppy food. Right now we have 3 puppies to feed. We're going to have, God willing, another 5 once they're released from Blue Pearl. And then again, Mommy is improving. Mommy Sosa is the mommy of the 8 Parvo puppies. So she is improving, but still at the 24-hour animal hospital currently. You guys keep saying I'm frozen. I'm not frozen any longer. You have to go out and come back in. I promise you. It's working just fine. The lighting is behind me. Sorry. So again, 2 lives saved in the middle of the night last night. And it's looping. It's because it froze and then I got you back. So once you step out and you come back in and watch from the beginning, I promise you it's going to be fine. It happens when I go out further on the property. But again, I just wanted to bring you all along. I figured I was here. We've been here all day, painting, getting things done. There is a donate button on this page, as always, because we are an ongoing mission of rescue, and we cannot continue without your support. We still have a lot of medical bills that we are trying to recover from. Over $40,000 we have spent on the Parvo family. Still trying to recover from that, from Lance, from Balto. Balto has made 0 improvement as of right now. So it's basically going to be one day at a time. We're going to give him obviously ample time and help him along. But all we're going to do is try our best and pray. We can't make ourselves any sicker than we have been worrying about all these dogs. We just do the best. And when I say the best, it's the best. There's nothing that we don't do for these dogs. No matter what the cost, we do everything and anything that they need. And you know that because we bring you along for the entire ride. So that's my Balto update. I'm sorry it's not a better one. Okay. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you for your generosity. Thank you for your donation. Again, any amount is not too small. Don't think making a donation of $5 is not going to help, because it adds up quickly. Thank you. I'll take it off of me so you can take one last peek, because I'm going to shut down, get back to work. Lots to do still. But yep, that's it. The cat condo's done. Where's Carol? She disappeared on us. We've got a lot done. Painting's pretty much done now. Just a little, maybe second coat here or there, but it's pretty much all the painting is done and putting everything together. Now we're basically waiting for some extra, the garages for the flooring, the fencing, and just getting our stuff up here, basically. It's the fencing that's holding us back from getting us in here. It has to be completely secured. What's the name of this paint color? Let me the blue that we're using? Hold on, I'll tell you. So this is the softer aqua blue, and Carol had the can, but again, I don't know what she did with it. Hold on. Carol. Carol? She's gone. She disappeared. Okay, what's in here? Okay, this one in here. This beautiful turquoise aqua is my favorite, honestly. It's a little bit brighter than the main room. And this is called Echo. It's Glidden. And it's Echo Lake Aqua. That is the color that I love. This is like the main color of the rescue house that we have currently, Rescue House 2. So I'll stand back. You can see it. It's really beautiful. And it changes color depending on the light. It gets lighter and darker. In here is lighter. And unfortunately, Carol took the paint can with her. So I don't know what it's called. She's somewhere. But I can find out for you. No big deal. We'll get it to you. I hope you enjoyed all the updates and coming along on this beautiful, beautiful Sunday. Everybody enjoy the rest of your weekend. And we will come live more tomorrow with more updates on our 2 new rescues and the Parvo babies. So again, we need puppy wet food and any donations to help us recover and to allow us to continue with our ongoing mission. This is Amy with 100 plus abandoned dogs of Everglades, Florida. And thank you in advance, everybody. for always being there, for your love, your support, and for always being excited for us and for all the work that we've worked so hard to get where we are today. We are so grateful and we are so humbled, making miracles happen every single day.